Montessori saw that it was commonly accepted that children were characterized by vivid imaginations. And she saw that people cited children's belief in Santa or the Tooth Fairy, or the fact that they'll take a stick and pretend it's a horse, or different things like that. She cited a society's characterization of children's imaginations. And we continue in society to encourage children to believe in things that are not real or to pretend in their play. But Montessori saw, especially in children under the age of 6, that these displays of imagination are not, in fact, the imagination at all. When children believe in Santa Claus or the Tooth Fairy, she says they are displaying their credulity, their ability to believe in things. Because the same adults who have told them everything they're learning about the world, that this is my nose and this is my eye, is also telling them that Santa Claus is a person who exists, or the Tooth Fairy does indeed come into your room at night. Children are believing that. It's not their imagination at work that they are so creative. They're literally just believing what a trusted adult has told them. So we have to be very careful with this with children under the age of 6. I've had, you know, numerous times where I've sat with elementary age children who found out for the first time that Santa Claus is not real or the Tooth Fairy is not real, and they're in tears at that loss. And that's because they truly believed. They weren't imagining it. The adults are imagining it when we share that, but the children are believing. So we have to be very cautious under the age of 6 when we tell children something that isn't real is true, because they can't distinguish the difference. And as far as children pretending and participating in pretend play, Montessori observed that a child who actually possesses a horse and can ride a horse regularly is far less likely to pretend that they're horse riding. And that's because they can do the real activity. The reason children pretend is that they want to participate in that real activity. And so what we have to give them under the age of 6 is as much opportunity to do the real activity as we possibly can. It's not the imagination that's causing them to pretend, it's a desire to do the real activity. So under the age of 6, we have an imagination that's pretty immature, that's taking in a lot of real things to help build itself, to build it to a more mature, you know, function. And we have to be very cautious about giving children something that's not real or encouraging pretend rather than giving them real things and letting them do real activities. At around the age of 6, this shifts. The reasoning mind starts to take over, and the imagination starts to function in a slightly different way. And at this time, we can use fantasy and stories to support the children's development. But under the age of 6, using fantasy is challenging, or we have to be cautious, because children will simply believe. So we'll talk more about what we do with elementary children and their imaginations.